Kia ora. We've created a series of instructional videos that will take you through how to create, edit, and track your application through the Ethics Review Manager platform. If you have an existing online forms website account that you've used for past applications, your existing account and applications are now on the Ethics RM system. Your password is the same. Enter the email address you used for your online forms account and password into the login screen and click the blue login button. To register a new account, click the green new user button. Enter your details and choose a password. Please read the terms and conditions and privacy policy. Once you have agreed to these, click the blue register button. You can now log into the Ethics RM system. Once you log in, the main work area screen will display. Here you can see any projects you've created or have access to. Using the buttons on the left-hand side of the screen, you can create folders to drag projects into and organize your work. The notifications button contains a list of alerts on the status of applications. For example, when applications have been submitted, validated, approved, or if you've received correspondence, please check your notifications regularly. The signatures button shows any authorization requests needing sign-off. Click the button to see a list of projects you have signed or have been requested to sign. The transfer button contains any applications transferred for you to accept permanent ownership of. The shared button contains any applications you have been granted access to by colleagues. This video will help you navigate through the process of how to create and submit a project and the project overview screen in Ethics RM. To start, click Create Project on the Action menu from the main work area. Fill in a project title. This will become the short title of your application going forward. From the drop-down menu, select HDEC Application. Now click Create. If the system does not respond, please check which browser you are using. Internet Explorer and older versions of Microsoft Edge are not supported, and you will need to use a modern browser such as Chrome. Once you have created a project, you will be able to see the main overview screen. This is divided between the action menu on the left and the tabs within the application. The navigation tab is highlighted by default. This shows the active sections of the form. For a new application, only the screening form will display until the application has been completed. If the application is in scope, the rest of the form will unlock. The screening section replaces the separate scope of review form. Answering the screening questions will determine whether the project is in scope and the review pathway it should take. If a project is out of scope, the system will create an out of scope letter stating so. If the project is in scope, the rest of the form will unlock. To begin completing the form, click the highlighted blue button, Screening Section Overview, page 1. The first two questions establish whether the project is health and disability research. Once these are answered, proceed to the next page by clicking Next on the action menu. The next page contains questions on the type of study and what it involves assessing its risks. Once the screen section is complete, the system will direct you to a review pathway. Click Proceed and the rest of the form will unlock. You can proceed to the next page or click Navigate to return to the overview screen. This will display all the sections you need to complete in order to submit the form. The Completeness Check button will return a list of questions still needing mandatory answers. Clicking a question on this list will go directly to the form where it may be answered. A new feature of Ethics RM is that documents and signatures are uploaded directly into the form. The HDEC application form contains several questions that will ask for a document to be uploaded. Click the green Upload button and select the document to upload. Uploaded documents can either be viewed from within the form or from the Documents tab on the Project Overview screen. If you're the coordinating investigator of your study, click the blue Sign button to sign the form. If you need to request a signature from the coordinating investigator, sponsor, or for locality approval, click the blue Request Signature button. When you have completed the form, click the Submit button. This will send the form to the HDEC Secretariat for validation. If your application is validated, you will receive a reply detailing whether your study will be reviewed at a full meeting or via the expedited pathway online. If your study is not validated, you'll receive the unlocking form asking for further information to get your study validated. Creating a new form is not necessary in EthicsRM. The existing form can be modified and submitted. If a submitted application has not been validated, it can be recalled by clicking the Recall Application button. The system will ask you if you wish to add a note for the reason why and will then return the application to you. The form may then be edited and resubmitted. The Correspond button allows you to send a message to the HDEC Secretariat within the EthicsRM system. This replaces the need to email the HDEC inbox separately. All correspondence will remain with the application for its duration. Attachments can be sent both ways via this function and will be how the HDEC Secretariat communicate any issues with the validation process. The main work area holds the information on the application status and more tabs. The Action Required row will indicate whether there is a task you need to complete in order to submit the form. A Yes in the field will be hyperlinked to the action needed. For example, completing part of the form, uploading a missing document, or obtaining an authorization signature. The Status row shows you what stage the application is at in the system. If it has been submitted, validated, assigned to a meeting, or given a decision, this is where it will be displayed. The Review reference is the HDEC reference number. In EthicsRM, the committee name is no longer part of the reference. Instead, the format is Year, Review Pathway, and a unique project ID number. The Data Modified shows when the last action was taken on the application by an applicant with right access. The Navigation tab is the default view which gives an overview of the application form questions. Clicking the hyperlinks will direct you to the specific section. The Documents tab shows a list of all documents uploaded to the application. The search bar can refine your search. Files can be downloaded and viewed individually or as a group. Clicking View Selected at the bottom right of the screen will combine all checked items by default and generate a single PDF combining all study documents. The Signatures tab will show any requested and signed off signatures on the form. The buttons to sign the form or to request a signature can be found within the application itself. The Collaborators tab shows all accounts that have access to the project. From this tab, you can edit their permissions and decide how much access they have within the form. For example, read-only or can create subforms, etc. The Submissions tab shows the form and submission history, previous versions of the form that were not validated by the HDEC Secretariat will display here. The Correspondence tab allows you to view and create messages to send to the HDEC Secretariat. If there is an unread message from the Secretariat, there will be a red notification on the tab, as well as an entry on the Notifications tile on the main work area. The History tab will show the major actions taken on the application. For example, creations, submission, validation, final decision, and any correspondence. If an item that has an HDEC letter, validation, or decisions, clicking Download will save a copy.